automated sprinkler system, and this refers to NFPA 13. So first I'll give you the idea about this automated sprinkler system, how the system works. Then in detail we'll discuss the types of sprinkler, the types of sprinkler system, then the different components and the hazards, etc. Here on screen, the components, you can update in the notes. Here is a tank and you can update these components. First is a tank and these are all pumps. These are pump sets. We have different types of pump. One is a main electrical pump. Second is a diesel pump. And in between, this is jockey pump. So we have a topic for pump selection. We'll discuss about these pumps in detail. At this level, these are pump sets. And the main pipe from the pump, you see, all this pump is connected to this main pipe. No? So this is called header. You can update. And after this, you see, from the header, you'll find the vertical pipe. This is called riser. Riser pipe. And this will continue in the shaft. Shaft means in the building shaft. I think you know what is building shaft. For example, here is office layout. So we will find different spaces. In between you'll find OTS, na? Open to sky, so that we can run the plumbing, drainage pipe, plumbing, water pipe or firefighting pipes or other services. So shaft or civil duct or OTS. Or a small opening for pipes, you can call pipe chase. So this vertical pipe will run, means riser, in the shaft. And on every floor, suppose a 10 floor building, so on each floor you'll find one horizontal pipe which is entering in the floor. Okay, so this horizontal pipe we can call as cross main, C-R-O-S-S, cross main. You can update this cross main or distribution pipe, cross main or. And on this, you see, suppose this is a ground floor, next first floor, this pipe will continue to second floor, then the cross main to second floor, then it will continue to the last. Okay, and on this cross main you'll find the branch pipes. Okay, and means this pipe we can write branch or range pipe. And on this range or on this branch pipe you'll find sprinklers. I think you know what is sprinkler, already discussed in class 1. Okay, so this is a sprinkler. And we have different types of sprinkler, we'll discuss. This I'm giving the idea at this level. And you'll find the control system, you'll find the valves, you'll find the other accessories, etc. So how this system works, simple. And what I'm explaining is wet sprinkler system. The default is a wet sprinkler system. We have dry sprinkler system, pre-action, deluge also. If you know wet sprinkler system, then we can think for, or we can deal with the other systems also. So the normal system, the default system, which is commonly used in India as well as in Gulf, is a wet sprinkler system. So wet sprinkler system we are calling because you'll find the water in the tank completely, and water, you'll also find the water in the complete pipe network till the sprinkler head. Means in wet sprinkler system, the water is permanently charged in the complete pipe network up to all the sprinklers. Okay, in dry and pre-action we have different case, we'll discuss later. But at this level, the normal system or the default sprinkler system is wet sprinkler system. It means this completely pipe, this pipe network filled with water. For example, if fire occurs somewhere here, so what happened? The because of heat, you know, in the sprinkler you'll find the bulb. The bulb, inside the bulb you'll find the liquid which will expand as per thermal rating. And red color bulb, you know, mostly, and the red color thermal rating says 70 degrees centigrade. So whenever temperature reaches to 70 degrees centigrade, the liquid inside the bulb will melt and break the bulb. And whenever bulb breaks, you'll get the passage for allowing the water through the sprinkler. And whenever the water allow through the sprinkler, there will be pressure difference in the line. Whenever pressure difference, because this system with the pressure switch and pneumatic system means this pressure system. So whenever there is a difference in the pressure in the line, what will happen? The pneumatic system sends that, and the pressure switch will operate and will open the valves and switch on the pump. Then the water will suck from the tank and supply on the affected area. Okay. And remember, only affected area sprinkler will open, not all the sprinklers, because we are dealing with a wet sprinkler system. We have other system also, like deluge system, in that all the sprinkler will operate at a time. That is special case, special system. But in normal sprinkler system, wet sprinkler system, only the affected area sprinkler will supply the water. And as the fire spreads, this sprinkler is affected, this will open. Like this, it will increase. So at a time, all the sprinkler will not work. In wet sprinkler system, in dry sprinkler system, even pre-action, except deluge. The deluge we'll discuss. We have total four types of system. So I think you got the idea. So with this information, let me start this sprinkler system, NFPA 13. Okay, so this is just a basic. So the first topic in this is sprinklers. Okay, sprinkler system is different, sprinkler is different. Sprinkler is just a device connected to the spring, is a part of sprinkler system. So first we'll talk about sprinkler. So you can find out the sprinkler here. We have different types. Most commonly you'll find the bulb type. You'll find the fusibling type also. So here you see, this is the bulb type sprinkler. And what about this one? This is fusible link. Not commonly used, but we have one more type. Fusible link means this link, this is a fusible link with a thermal rating. A metal, aluminium or any other material, will melt with the temperature. So this metal suppose will melt at 75 degrees centigrade, for example. Whenever temperature increases to 75 degrees, this will melt. This is a fusible link. Whenever it melt, it will allow to open this valve, and water will come out from this. Okay, so like mechanism is same, but this is a fusible link type. This is a bulb type. Most commonly you'll find the bulb type. Okay, so what are the components of this sprinkler? This threaded portion is called shank. Okay, shank. And here this is frame. This is completely frame. Okay, and here is a bulb or thermal sensor, mechanical thermal sensor. And here is the opening. Whenever this break, the water start flowing from this point, from this opening. And remember, this bulb is connected here, and the dia, the standard dia of this opening, we can call orifice or sprinkler orifice. Remember, the standard is half inch. We have 3x4 inch, 1 inch, and other dia also, the orifice size, but standard is half inch. And remember, standard half inch means we have a K factor 5.6. But what is K factor? Don't worry. At this level, just you make a note of this. In between, before starting this calculation, I'll send you one video. In that video, you'll find the animation, the animated animation video. In that, you'll find how we got this K factor. And we have different orifice size and different K factor. Don't worry, we'll discuss more about this K factor at the time of calculation. And before that, I'll send you an animated video also to get the idea how we are getting this K factor. Okay, with the experimental setup. Next. So apart from this, at the bottom here, this round, this is called deflector. Here it is written, deflector. And remember, this will not rotate. This is a fixed one. And reflector is used to supply the water on the wide area. Because if I remove this reflector, the water will directly throw down and it will not cover much area. So with the deflector, it will create a sprinkler form, so it can cover wide area. Okay, so this is a deflector, deflector on the sprinkler. It's not movable, it's a fix. So it will not rotate, it's a fixed item. Okay, so these are the different components of sprinkler. Now we'll talk about the types of sprinkler. So we have different types of sprinkler. Next, we have types of sprinkler. The first type, what we learned just now, this one is a pendant sprinkler. Why we used to call pendant? Because here the pipe will connect, the branch pipe, and the branch pipe will connect to the main pipe. Okay, the installation detail is different, we'll discuss later. At present, I'm just showing the idea. So pendant sprinkler means this is used to cover the fire below the fall ceiling level, or without fall ceiling, we can say below the pipe level. So you see, a sprinkler designed to install in such a way that the water stream is directed downwards against the deflector. When this break, the water will supply downwards against the deflector, no? Means below the pipe level, or with fall ceiling, below the fall ceiling, to cover the fire below the fall ceiling. Okay, so this is the first type. And in pendant type, we have two more types. The second is recess pendant. Technically, recess pen, normal pendant, recess pendant, or concealed pendant. We have one more type. All are same technically, but you'll find difference as per the interior requirement. For example, you see, normal pendant, many times the interior will not accept because this will affect to the interior, to look ugly in interior. So in that case, we can go for recess pendant. Recess pendant means you can see with the cover plate, with the chrome coating with the cover plate, so that it will not affect to the appearance. But in some cases, the interior will not even accept this recess pendant. So for that, we have concealed. Concealed means with a cap. You see, here is a sprinkler, and this cap will use the cap to cover this. And in the false ceiling, it appear like this. You see, this image is for false ceiling. So in the false ceiling, you'll find only cap, and the cap is pressed or with some glue. And again, when in case of fire, first the cap will come out with the temperature. As the temperature increase, this glue will melt and this cap will drop down first. Then again, this bulb will affect, and supply water. Mechanism is same, but appearance point of view, this is concealed type. For interior point of view, not visible as per the interior requirement. So these are the three types of pendant sprinkler. Okay, next we have upright. You can see upright on screen. You see, if you talk about the pendant, the deflector, you can see it's a straight deflector, means round, but there is no curve. But in case of upright, here you can notice this deflector is not straight, it is somewhat like umbrella, curve type. First difference. And second thing is, the upright will install in the same way. Suppose this will connect to the pipe. Upright means, the name will give you the idea, upright. So this will install above the pipe level, or I can say above the false ceiling level. With false ceiling, above the false ceiling. Without false ceiling, above the pipe level. So a sprinkler designed to install in such a way, the water is directed upwards against the deflector. Water will directly upwards to the against the deflector. So when the water come out, it will form a pattern of water like this. So this is above the false ceiling or above the pipe level. And the best example of upright is in the store area. In the store area, generally there is no false ceiling. And if I use the pendant in the store area, what will happen? For example, here is a storeroom. In the storeroom, you may find some items like the old almara or something. So if I use the pendant sprinkler, what will happen? When the water come out, because of this tall item, the water may restrict. So we'll go for upright. Upright means the direction is up, then it will flow. Means the water will go up, then it can cover the wide area. If there is restriction also, it can cover. So the best example of upright is the store area, or the upright is used to cover the fire above the false ceiling. Because above the false ceiling also, we have services, we require safety. So we can use this upright. Okay. Next we have some more types. Sidewall sprinklers. Here you can see the image of sidewall. This is going to install in the wall. In case, again, as per the in this image, you can find this is a recess type sidewall with a cover plate. Again, as per interior. So you can find this sidewall in the wall. You cannot see the pipe. Pipe is concealed inside. So for example, a bedroom or a small rooms, if there is no false ceiling, or as per the interior demand, we can go for the sidewall, and the sidewall will supply the water away from the wall. Means whenever this break, the water is going to be strike on this deflector. The deflector is different here. Okay, see, it's like a shade, and here if the partly deflector, so it will stuck here. Then it will come out like a quarter of a spear. For example, if you consider a spear, from this point I can take a quarter of spear, so you get this pattern. And this is a point from where the water come out, so it will create a pattern like a quarter of a spear. Okay, and away from the wall. So this sidewall sprinkler will use without false ceiling or as per the interior requirement, because without false ceiling, if I run the pipe will be visible and will affect to the interior. So we can go for concealed pipes, then we can use. And but this sidewall is not for the big halls or big big open areas, because it cannot cover the middle part. No? For small rooms, okay. For a small room, we can cover from the sides, but if it is a big open area or an open office, we cannot use the sidewall. Or else sidewall we can use to cover the fire for side, and for center again pendants are required, depend as per the requirement, as per the interior requirement. Next, so this is sidewall type. Next we have a spray sprinkler. You can also write open type sprinkler. Here spray sprinkler means open type sprinkler, and in the image you can notice there is no bulb here. There is no sensing device. There is no sensor. So at this level, just you learn the open type sprinkler or spray sprinkler, but where it is used and how it will work, we'll discuss at the time of learning deluge system, D-E-L-U-G, deluge system. So this is not used for sensing the fire. This is just used to supply the water on the affected area. Then how the system understand there is a fire means where is the detection system. So we have additional detection system in deluge system. But don't worry, at this level understand the construction only. The purpose you can understand, or the use you can understand at the time of learning deluge sprinkler system. After this topic we have the type of sprinkler system only. So at this level, in open spray sprinkler there is no bulb, that's it. Okay, or you can write here use in deluge, D-E-L-U-G, deluge sprinkler system. Next, so you'll find some more theory, you can go through this, and you'll find that temperature rating table. This is directly from NFPA, and you see whenever the table or the chart from NFPA, you'll get the reference section code. So this table number is 6.2.5.1. So you need to memorize this course and sections also. It will be useful at the time of designing. Anyhow, when you practice, automatically you can memorize all this. Okay, but the sections, this table numbers, section numbers, code numbers are important. Because many time when you submit a design report, because in actual practice at the initial stage, based on the as per the project requirement, we'll study the project, its architectural layout, and we'll submit the initial report. In the report we require all this referencing, which code, which section, etc. You need to justify, means whether the sprinkler system is applicable for that project or not. If applicable, you need to give the section number, the codes, etc. If not applicable also, you need to give this a section number. In this one, so section is not applicable for the type of building, whether it's so generally for low rise of building, for a small project sprinkler is not required. Anyhow, the type of system requirement as per the type of building we'll discuss at the time of learning IBC, International Building Code, chapter 3 and chapter 9. Next, so some information is given here about the temperature rating. In this you see most commonly 57 to 77 temperature rating is ordinary orange or red color. Most commonly we'll find other colors with the other thermal rating also we'll use at the time of calculation. So this table coding is important. Next, temperature rating, what I explained, the same table you'll find with the colors also here. For example, you see red color is up to 68 degree. You'll find some different, some change or variation in the temperature as per the codes. As per NFPA, you see up to 77 degree centigrade, most commonly 68 or 70 degree centigrade, this red color or orange. And you see this yellow color, 79 degree centigrade. You see for very high temperature, black color, 260 degree centigrade, like furnace, boiler, etc., industrial application. But in sprinkler we have two types as per construction, means already we learn pendant, upright, etc. As per the type of bulb, we have two types of sprinkler as per the construction, you know, pendant, upright, sidewall, open type sprinkler. Again in pendant we have recess, even in sidewall also we have recess, etc. But as per the diameter of the bulb, we have two options. You can read here. You see standard response, 5 mm bulb. But we have quick response, 3 mm bulb. So as per the diameter of bulb also, these sprinklers are classified. So quick response, 3 mm and standard, 5 mm. The diameter of the bulb means this sensor. And inside you'll find the liquid, which can expand as per the thermal reading. It can be alcohol or any other liquid, depend as per the manufacturer. Next. And here you see this table 6.2.3.1 sprinkler discharge characteristics amplification, and in this also you'll find the K value. What I explained, for example, you see if you talk about the half inch, most commonly you see this half inch with the K factor range is 5.3 to 5.8, standard we are taking 5.6 and half inch. This type we have other discharge rating also, but most commonly this is standard, and we'll use this table at the time of designing. Don't worry, just I'm giving the idea at this level. And if you have the hard copy online, you can highlight this point. Classroom also you can highlight this 5.6 and this half inch orifice. And we have some important formulas also we'll use at the time of calculation. Here this formula, Q into K into P to the power half, or P equal to Q by K whole square. These are formulas from NFPA we'll use at the time of calculation to find out pressure, or if you know Q or K, or if you know pressure and K, you can find out the Q discharge. Q is a flow rate. This 7 PSI operating pressure. Highlight this, we'll use in the calculation. But don't worry, we'll discuss about the pressure. So in the sprinkler system, as per NFPA guidelines, the pressure should not be less than 7 PSI. So this point is important. We'll calculate after calculation. If you get the pressure more than 7 PSI, we'll take the calculate value. If less than 7, we'll take minimum 7. Okay, and I think you know what is PSI. Next, with this information, the types of sprinkler, we'll discuss the type of sprinkler system now. Okay, so we have 4 type of sprinkler system. You can read it on screen also. First is what wet sprinkler system. The second is what the dry sprinkler. Third is a pre-action, and the fourth is a deluge sprinkler system. Deluge or delute. So wet sprinkler system, you already know. In wet sprinkler system, the water is permanently charged in the pipe network up to the sprinkler, means in till the sprinklers, means the water is available in the tank, in the pipe, completely pipe network up to the sprinkler. So you know what is wet sprinkler system, what we learn at the beginning. But dry sprinkler system means what? Any idea online? This is NFPA 13 module sprinkler system. So NFPA 13 means water-based sprinkler system. Water-based. If you talk about CO2, that code is different. The module is different. So don't confuse. Dry sprinkler system is, don't think that it's a gas system or it's a CO2 or it's a FM200. No. Dry sprinkler system also a water system. Then why we used to call dry sprinkler system? I'll explain. So here in bracket you can write, this dry sprinkler system is water system only. Means all are water-based sprinkler system. If you talk about CO2 system, FM200, that is waterless system. Waterless system is different and dry system is different. Dry system is a water system only. Then why we are calling dry sprinkler system? I'll explain now. Simple concept. First of all, the reason why we are dealing with a dry sprinkler system compared with the wet sprinkler system. Here on screen, you know the concept of sprinkler system, the water supply from the tank through the pump, from the header, riser, cross pin, branch pipe, then finally come up with the sprinkler. So you know wet sprinkler. But in case if I use wet sprinkler system in UK or in Australia or in US or in Canada, these are the western countries location, and you know in this location same time throughout the year the temperature is less than 0. Or in some parts of Gulf also, or even in India also, in some regions you'll find the temperature less than 0. like Jammu Kashmir or some location, if in a particular location, if the temperature less than zero, and if you use wet sprinkler system, so what will happen? You see, this system pipe from outside or from outside the building or from the cellar, it will enter in that building, and this riser also is outside, it's not inside, means it's open. So if the temperature less than zero, if I use wet sprinkler system, there is a chance the water in the line will freeze. If the water freezes, then in case of fire, there is no supply of water. So to avoid that freezing of water, we are using dry sprinkler system. So how exactly? So in dry sprinkler system, what happened? You'll find the water in the tank, and generally this tank is insulated tank, so that the water will not freeze in the tank. Or if required, we'll add antifreeze elements, or if further required, we can go for heaters also in the tank, so that the water should not freeze. But the water is not available in the pipeline, means from this point one starting, suppose these are point one starting of the pump, till the last sprinkler, suppose this is point two, this is the last sprinkler for example, means in the entire pipe network the water is not charged. Instead of water, will charge a gas. The gas can be the normal air or it can be a CO2. But don't think that if I use CO2 or the CO2 is used to control the fire. Now or ignore CO2, just consider normal air. So this pipe charged with the compressed air or compressed gas, say air, so compressed air, so that the air will not freeze with a very high temp, with a very low temperature. In cryogenics it can, but little like liquid oxygen, but in the normal temperature it will not freeze. Okay, so to avoid freezing of water, in the line you'll find the compressed gas. Why compressed gas? For example, if fire occurs somewhere here, because of the temperature increase in temperature, you know, the bulb will break and in wet sprinkler system, directly the water will come out, and pressure difference, because of pressure difference, the system will activate and suck the water from the tank and supply in the affected area. But in this case, whenever sprinkler break, the compressed gas release. Whenever compressed gas release, again because of release of gas, there is a pressure difference in the line that is used for activating the system. So whenever pressure difference in the line, whenever gas releases or the compressor releases, there will be pressure difference in the line, and the pneumatic system or the pressure switch will switch on the pump and open the valve. Then the water will suck by the pump from the tank and supply on the affected area. So finally, we are using water to control the fire in dry sprinkler system also. So it's not waterless system, so water system only we are calling dry system, because initially we are dealing with the compressed air, not with the water, to avoid freezing of water. That's it. Okay, clear. And we have some condition. Normally for wet sprinkler system, for one riser, for one system, we can go for up to 1000 sprinkler. But in case of dry system, the limitation is up to 500 sprinkler for one system. And remember, the delay of supplying water is allowed up to 60 seconds, means 1 minute. Means within 1 minute, the water should reach on the affected area, on the affected area sprinkler. Means, for example, if it's a 10 floor building, so we'll check for the last sprinkler on the top floor. So for the last sprinkler on the top floor, the water should reach within 60 seconds. If it is not reaching, then we'll go for a separate riser to cover that floor. Suppose up to 7th floor, the water is reaching up to before 60 seconds as per the testing. So for above floors, we'll go for a separate riser with the same header, so that it can supply the water directly. So depend as per the requirement. So I think you got the idea online about dry sprinkler system. So don't confuse dry sprinkler system also a water-based system. Okay, just to avoid freezing, we are using this concept. Clear? Yes. You see, at this level, just we are dealing with the basics. we are learning the systems and all. After completing this, we have a calculation part. And if you talk about the pipe sizing for sprinkler system, we have ready-made tables from the NFPA as per light hazard, ordinary hazard, etc. And as per the number of sprinkler, we have the pipe size. And remember, already we discussed at the beginning class, in the first class, I think, remember, this firefighting is designed based on the probability. So the pipe sizing is not like chilled water pipe sizing. The pipe sizing is based on the probability. So we'll follow the course from NFPA. So we have a standard table. As per the number of sprinkler, we'll get the size of the pipe of this branch. And generally, this cross main or this riser will take 4 inch. If it is a single, if it is a only sprinkler system, if it is a combined with a hose reel or combined with a class 1, class 2 system, etc., the size will change. Anyhow, we'll discuss, don't worry. At this level, just we are dealing with the type of system. Next. So, next we have pre-action system. Pre-action also interesting. You see, except wet sprinkler system or dry, wet in India as well as in Gulf, except a few locations, and dry sprinkler system is in Western countries. Or in India and Gulf also, in the required location where the temperature throughout the year less than zero also. So in Western countries, dry, but pre-action relief system is only for special case. What is we'll discuss now. So I think there is no confusion in wet and dry, and the same theory is given in the notes. You see, wet sprinkler system is used for the location where the temperature throughout the year above 0 degrees centigrade. Dry sprinkler system is used for the location where the temperature less than 0 degrees centigrade. So this two system is used. Apart from before pre-action, I'll show you one small video clip about this dry sprinkler system.
System ready for operation.
Yeah, so is this visible online? Yeah, so just have a look.
Operation. The sprinkler pipe contains air under pressure, shown here in yellow. The water supply contains water under pressure.
You see, the yellow color is air and the blue color is water. So what is available up to this only? It's not completely in the pipe. Okay.
Shown here in blue, the area located just beneath the clapper is open to atmosphere through the alarm port and the pipe connections to the automatic drain valve and alarm devices, shown here in orange. When a fire activates a sprinkler, the air under pressure in the sprinkler piping is...
Here you'll find the upright sprinkler. Upright means above the pipe level, na?
Released. The valve opens, allowing water to spray out of the sprinkler. Water will only spray out of sprinklers that have been activated by the fire. Water will also flow through the alarm port to the alarm devices to indicate water flow. Let's take a look at the system in action. To reset the valve after the fire is under control, the main control valve is manually closed to shut off water, and the air supply control valve is closed to shut off the air supply. Then the main drain valve, the low body drain valve, and all auxiliary drains are opened to drain water from the system. Once the system stops discharging water, all drain valves are closed except the main drain valve. The plunger of the automatic drain valve is depressed to verify that it is open and the system is completely drained. Replace all sprinklers that have operated. Press down the reset knob to allow the clapper to reseat. Air and then water pressure are restored and the valve is returned to service.
You see, you'll find this alarm also. So whenever the water enters, the alarm also activates. And this valve will open. And this part blue is water and above is air with all pressure gauges. So after controlling the fire, again will charge with the air and this side with the water. Okay, so whenever pressure difference, this will work. So whenever the air releases, there is a pressure difference, then automatically this valve will open and the water will supply, alarm will activate, etc. Next. So the same theory is given what we learned just now. You can go through once. Next we have special type, pre-action and deluge system. So let me complete this two system also in today's session. Pre-action, the name will give you the idea, means before actual action, one pre-action. And why this pre, by the need of this pre-action? So remember, this pre-action is used or installed in the area where there is a chance the sprinklers may damage accidentally. For example, a workshop. In a workshop, suppose the transport of the pipe from one side to other side, or tall equipment from other side, one side to other side, or trolleys in within the workshop. What happened? Because of the tall equipment, the tall equipments may touch to the sprinkler and sprinkler may damage accidentally. If I use wet sprinkler system or dry sprinkler system, whenever the sprinkler breaks, in wet sprinkler system immediately supply water. In dry sprinkler system, delay up to 60 seconds. So what will happen if the sprinkler damage accidentally, quickly the supply of water, and whenever supply of water, the alarm activate, the people get panic, so a lot of issues, and the water will damage and that area also affected. So we need to stop the supply of water, then clean that area till the time the work will affect. So to avoid these issues, we are using pre-action system. Interesting. In pre-action system, you'll find two circuit, one circuit of pipe connected with a sprinkler. And remember, pre-action system also type of dry sprinkler system. So here you can write here pre-sprinkler system in bracket type of dry sprinkler system. Means this is one of the type of dry sprinkler system. Means the water is not permanently charged in the circuit. You'll find the compressed gas. So here you can find out one line. You can see the arrow. This is used to supply the water in case of fire, but initially with the compressed gas. This is one circuit. Parallelly, you'll find one more circuit with the heat detectors. So what will happen? For example, if this sprinkler, for example, I'm continuing this pipe. Say one sprinkler here. One sprinkler. Suppose this sprinkler accidentally breaks. So when it accidentally break, what will happen? Only the gas in the circuit will release. And you'll find two alarms in this. One is the initial alarm and second is the main alarm. So whenever the sprinkler damage accidentally, the gas will release, and this, because of release of gas, only the initial alarm activate, indicating that there is a damage of sprinkler and the maintenance people should take action. This is pre-action. But the water will not supply. Water will supply only if actual fire occurs. Because you see, the detection system is parallelly running. This is heat detectors. These are heat detectors parallelly run with the sprinkler, with the separate wiring. Okay. So if actual fire occurs somewhere here, what will happen? Before breaking the sprinkler, the heat detector will activate. Why? Because the heat detector temperature rating is 8 to 10 degrees centigrade less compared to the sprinkler. For example, sprinkler say 70 degrees centigrade, it will activate 70 degrees centigrade. So heat detector will activate at 60 degrees centigrade, means 10 degrees less. So it will activate initial before breaking the sprinkler bulb. Okay, so if actually fire somewhere in some location, what happened? The heat detector will sense the heat, and say 60 degrees centigrade reaches, it will sense the heat and give the signal to the control system, fire control system or the pneumatic system, and open this valve and ready to supply the water. And when the temperature reaches to 70 degrees centigrade, the sprinkler will break. Whenever sprinkler break, the gas will release and the valve is already open. So the pressure difference in the water side also. So the pump will switch on. Then the water will supply in the pipe and supply on the affected area. It's like a dry sprinkler system only. But the additional option is pre-action. Before the actual action, main action, if the sprinkler damage accidentally. without fire. Okay, so if the sprinkler activate or break accidentally without any fire, only the gas will release and initial alarm will activate. But the actual supply of water only when the heat detector sends the heat. And when the heat detector sends the heat, it will activate the main alarm also, so that the people can come out from that area. Okay, so this is pre-action system, only for a special case. Clear? Online? So the same theory you can find in the notes. Go through once what I explained. Next, we have one more special type that is called deluge sprinkler system. Or deluge sprinkler system. This is also a special case. So in deluge sprinkler system, at a time, all the sprinkler will activate. Means at a time, the supply of water from all the sprinklers. Okay. And this is also a dry type, but not exactly, because in dry type, we are charging with the gas. But in this system, there is no gas, nothing. So open type. So here you see, in deluge sprinkler system, you'll find circuit 1 and circuit 2, like previous heat detectors. But where this system is used? This system is used for high hazards, where there is a chance the fire will spread rapidly or quickly. Like for example, here, suppose is a godown. In that you'll find a barrels with the flammable liquids. Storage area of flammable liquid. So what happen if fire occur in one tank? Within no time it will spread, na? But similarly, this crackle storage or any other highly flammable fluids or material, in that area we are using this deluge system. The concept is, you see, the chances in this area, like highly flammable area or storage area, there is a chance when in case of fire, the fire will quickly spread. So what we'll do, if fire occurs somewhere here at this point, all the sprinkler will activate. Means wherever the fire occur on that particular area, all the sprinkler will supply the water. So what will happen? Before spreading the fire, we are supplying the water on all the area, na? So this is for higher hazards. Means at a time, all the sprinkler will supply the water. So for that reason, the sprinkler with what? Open sprinkler head. So we learn open spray sprinkler. So we are using open spray sprinkler in deluge sprinkler system. Means this is used only to supply the water. Means there is no detection. Okay, for detection, parallelly, you'll find heat detectors parallelly with the sprinkler. So when if the fire occurs somewhere here, this sprinkler will act, this heat detector will sense, give the signal to the control system, and the control system will open the valve and switch on the pump and supply the water in the circuit 1, and supply water, and the water will come out through all the sprinklers. So before increasing the fire, we are supplying the water in the complete area. Okay, so this means the deluge system work in this way. Clear online? Simple concept. And this is not for the complete building, this is only for special areas, high hazard areas. Okay. And what I explained, the same you'll find in the theory. Please go through once. And this concludes the type of sprinkler systems. But we have three more type as per the arrangement of pipe. You see, a sprinkler arrangement. For sprinkler arrangement, we have three system. One is a tree sprinkler arrangement, second is a loop, and third is a gridded type. Okay, so this we'll discuss in the next session. So go through once all the sprinkler system. So tomorrow we'll go for the type of sprinkler arrangement, then we'll discuss the type of hazards, then the calibration part, as I said, pipe shuttle method and hydraulic method in calculation. Okay, with the sample project.